the way. Who got a watch? Who got the time? I'm raising the clock. Even in my feelings, grind don't stop. Got big dreams, want big rocks. I got plans, who got talk? That is real cheap, but it's really gold cost. I'm trying to get these things, building buyers with my friends.
Let's get into this look right here. I filmed this brown smoky eye, super obsessed, fluffy lashes, wing liner. I didn't show you the face makeup because I did an updated flawless foundation routine. If you would like to see how I do my base makeup, I will link that later on in the video. And I'm also gonna show you how I installed this gorgeous highlighted Yaki wig from OMG Queen Hair. This wig is highlighted so beautifully. Y'all already know I have been obsessed with Yaki straight hair as of late, and the highlights just made this wig pop even more. If you're not already subscribed to my YouTube channel, what are you doing, baby? Hit the subscribe button down below, and also make sure that that bell is turned on so you're notified as soon as your girl posts a new video. And if you're not watching this video in 4K right now, what are you doing with your life? Go ahead and get that quality turned all the way up so you can see exactly what is going on. And if you would like to see how I got this full look, hair plus makeup, y'all know what to do. Definitely keep watching. So let's go ahead and unbox this wig from OMG Queen Hair. It arrived with freebies, love that. And here is the natural Yaki straight texture of the hair. It has blonde highlights in it. It also has a 13x6 inch lace frontal, 3 wig combs in the front, 1 wig comb in the back. Let's go ahead and throw this wig on our head and see what we are working with. I'm going to line up the lace so that it matches my hairline perfectly. Next, we're gonna remove that excess lace around the ear tab area. And I like to do this with eyebrow scissors because it's smaller and it really gets around the ear great. Also, I like doing this before I install my wigs because I feel like it makes the lace lay super flat, so when you install your wig, it doesn't have any lumps or ripples in it, which we definitely don't want. So I'm using the Ebon Wonder Lace Spray in the Supreme. This is the one in the black can, and I'm spraying this right in front of the hairline, y'all. And I'm gonna wait for this to get tacky, and then we're gonna go ahead and install the wig. So you could do a couple of layers with this if you would like, but I typically only do one because I do like to remove my wigs every night typically. So let's go ahead and pull that lace down. And as soon as I press it with the comb, it should stick. So I did not apply any foundation to my lace today. I wanted to do something different. I just wanted to test things out to see if the lace would still blend if I don't apply my foundation. And I do like to go in with a blow dryer on a cool setting just to make sure that the lace is nice and secure to my head. We're gonna melt it. And then I kept it on for about 10 minutes. And here is what we're working with. Let's go ahead and remove that excess lace, y'all. So we're gonna trust the process, y'all. I'm trying something different, not applying any foundation under the lace because it does stick better when you don't have anything under the lace, to be honest. But I wanna see if I can get a good melt with it still. So I'm going in with the Ebon Melting Spray and the black bottle, and we're gonna melt this lace and see if it still blends even though I didn't apply any tint spray or any foundation to this lace, y'all. So let's go ahead and melt the lace yet again. I'm going to put the elastic melting band on and I'm going to start my makeup. I already did my brows off camera. We're gonna clean up underneath them with the MAC Studio Finish Concealer in NC45. I love this formula. I also love this color, but I don't love it for all over my eye area. So I'm just going to apply this in the upper half of my eyelids to highlight under my brows, and we're going to blend it out with a fluffy brush.
Next, I'm going to take a darker shade in the MAC Studio Finish Concealer. This is NW43, and we're going to apply it all over the eyelids. I do find that the NW shades do cover up discoloration better than the NC shades because it's just a little bit more orange tone than the NC shade. So I am using this on my eyelids only and blending it up into the crease. Doing something a little bit different on the eyelids today, we're using the NARS High Pigment Longwear Liner in the shade Mambo, and it's just a medium dark brown shade. It is warm tone, and I'm applying this all over the lid, and we're gonna blend it out up into the crease just a little bit, y'all. So all of my eyeshadow is coming from the Tartlet Toasted Eyeshadow Palette today. I'm first going in with the shade Cozy in the crease area. It is a medium warm tone brown, and I am just applying this with a fluffy big dome brush. And next we're going to go into the crease with the shade Fireside, which is a matte dark brown shade. It's more of a cool tone, and we're going to apply this right into the crease. We're not bringing it up. And then on the lids, I am using NARS eyeshadow in Mekong, but y'all, I had no idea that this is no longer available from NARS, so I'm going to link an alternative for y'all. This one does have a little bit of shimmer in it, but it's not necessary for this look, to be honest. Next, we're gonna do a black wing liner. You can use any black liquid liner that you love. It really does not matter the brand as long as you like it and it's easy for you to apply your wing liner. Now we're going to apply mascara to our upper lashes to get them prepped for false lashes. This tutorial is just for this smoky brown eyeshadow. So if you're interested in my flawless foundation makeup base, definitely click the link in the upper right hand corner. Let's finish up this eyeshadow look. I'm going in with the Cozy eyeshadow again. It was the first shade that we used in the crease, and I'm smoking it out under the lower lash line. And then I'm taking that Fireside shade just on the outer half of the under lash line so I can get it nice and smoked out, y'all. Next, we're going to apply a black eyeliner to the lower waterline. This is the ColourPop Cream Gel Liner in the shade Swerve. For lashes today, I'm going in with two pairs from Amazon. I will link it on my Amazon storefront, which will be in the description box down below, as well as pinned in a comment down below for y'all. But I just stacked those two lashes, and as you can see, it's giving fluffy mink lashes. Absolutely love this combination with this smoky eye. It is perfect for going out during the holiday season, y'all. I'm also applying mascara to my lower lashes. Y'all already know how I feel about that. And in the inner corner of the eyes, I'm using the MAC Extra Dimension Skin Finish in Oh Darling just to highlight that area. And this is the finished look, y'all. I think it's super cute, but simple and perfect for the holidays. So now it's time to finish styling this wig. I'm first gonna go in with this brush to fully detangle the hair. This is the Evolve Flow Through Detangler brush. As you can see, the highlights on this wig are super bomb. Like, they highlighted this wig, but it looks so professionally done. I love how the hair is highlighted on this Yaki wig. I have never had a Yaki wig with highlights in it. I believe this is my first one. Yeah, it is. So I decided to do a middle parting for the style. So I am going around the entire parting area with the Ebon wax stick, and then I'm going to spray it down with a little bit of the olive oil spritz as well. This combination, and then using the hot comb, just gets that parting area super flat. So let's go ahead and get that parting area nice and sleek, y'all. So once the parting area is nice and flat, I'm gonna go in with this Chi Original flat iron, and I'm going to use this just to get the hair nice and sleek. It's already straight, but I do like to go over straight hair once I receive it, because when the wig is in its packaging, it can get like little dips in just like weird spots where the hair isn't super straight, if you know what I mean. So I just like to go back and make sure that that hair is looking nice and sleek so that you can look really put together by the time you're done styling the wig. But it really doesn't take that much time. I'm not doing this in sections. I'm literally just grabbing some pieces and running the flat iron through the hair. So it's just like a really quick straighten, y'all, as you can see. And here is the final look, y'all. I really feel like it came together. I love this entire look. Let me know what you think in the comments down below.
I had so much fun filming this look for y'all. It's been a minute since I've done a smoky eye like this. This is giving me OG makeup doll feels right now. If you know, you know. Thank y'all so much for your continued love and support. I really do appreciate it. If you are interested in checking out this wig from OMG Queen Hair, y'all know what to do. Check the description box down below and I will leave any coupon codes that they provide me with there as well. And if you have not already checked out my latest video, go ahead and click the box right here and keep the party going, y'all.